Intel offered a peek at some of the performance benefits coming in its fourth generation of core processors, codenamed Haswell, and due in 2013. Haswell is targeted at Ultrabooks, the thin and light PC answer to Apple's MacBook Air. It brings higher performance over the current third generation chips, which are based on a platform called Ivy Bridge. In a demonstration at the company's developer forum event in San Francisco on Tuesday, Intel put Ivy Bridge up against Haswell, and Haswell showed its performance.
But Haswell is going to be delivering yet another 2x the capability at the same power envelope.
Haswell could nearly double the battery life of Ultrabooks by achieving the same tasks at half the power.
The same core running at the same power, this is the third generation core technology, comparing to a Haswell fourth generation core technology running at less than half the power, and see whether you could see the performance difference. So we're running about half the power, and you could see it is about the same performance.
That could push Ultrabook battery life from around 6 hours to 12 hours, or perhaps even more depending on the hardware, although it's not clear when these improvements might come. Intel has yet to provide a precise date in 2013 for the launch of the Haswell chips. Intel has been pushing Ultrabooks, but early sales have been disappointing, partly due to high prices. There are more than 70 Ultrabooks with Intel chips on the market, and some upcoming models with Windows 8 will transform and double as tablets.
They're called Yoga because it has a huge amount of flexibility, and you could do all kinds of things and use it as a tablet mode.
The Intel exec used some of his keynote to demonstrate other technologies, including an integration of Nuance's Dragon voice recognition into a laptop.
Hello, Dragon. Search Amazon for sunglasses.
Here are the Amazon results for sunglasses.
The first laptops with the Siri-like voice recognition could be out by the end of this year. And in a collaboration with MasterCard, Touch and Go payments were demonstrated with a PayPass credit card and a laptop with embedded sensors.
And I can see here that immediately on this page, it is detected that my laptop has Tap and Go capabilities by having NFC built in. So let's just go ahead and pay by that way. Take my card. And just like that, all of my information has been authenticated from the cloud, has gone ahead and filled in all the forms, don't need to hassle with those pesky passwords and a bunch of other stuff that I keep rattling around in my head. We have gone through multi-step authentication to make sure that this purchase happens. Looks good there, and that order is on the way for me.
The Intel Developer Forum continues until Thursday. In San Francisco, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.